Welcome to Texas A&M University Commerce Library's tutorial on Wharton Research Data Services. WRDS provides researchers with one location to access over 350 terabytes of data across multiple disciplines, including accounting, banking, finance, and more. This tutorial will cover how to request access to WRDS, what databases the libraries are subscribed to within WRDS platform, what is Compustat, and how to find particular data in this database. To begin, visit the library's homepage at tamuc.edu/library. Under Find Resources, click on Databases, click on W on top of the page, and scroll down to WRDS. This is the homepage for WRDS, and if it's your first time using this platform, you need to register for an account. Click on Register on top of the page, fill out the form, and submit it. Please be aware that registration for an account is not immediate and may take a day and two to activate. After you have registered and logged in, you'll be taken to WRDS homepage, which allows you to search data by vendors, concepts, companies, and variables. Here, under your subscriptions, you'll see what databases our libraries are subscribed to. For today's demonstration, we'll use Compustat. Compustat provides more than 300 annual and 100 quarterly income statement, balance sheet, statement of cash flows, and supplemental data items. For most companies, annual history is available back to 1950 and quarterly history back to 1962 with monthly market history back to 1962. Within Compustat, there are several data sets. For this tutorial, let's choose North America. And within North America, there are still more data sets. And let's select Fundamentals Annual. A query form opens, and we should fill it out with some information like date and variables. In the first step, we should select the date range, either data date or fiscal year. Let's do it from 2015, January 1st, to 2019, January 1st. In step 2, you may search companies by their codes, such as ticker, SEC, or NAIX. Let's keep it on ticker. Then you should enter the code manually if you know it, or look it up here. For example, we want to have data about two companies. First, let's find the code for Walmart. Okay, this is the company we want. Then, we should select the identifier, the code, ticker, and click on Add Codes to List. Because we are looking for another company as well, we should go back to search box and start over. This time, let's look for Amazon. Select the company, the identifier, and then add the code to the list. Now we have two codes to add to the query. Here they are. You may also upload the file of several companies that you already have by clicking on Browse. Step 3 is query variables to select variables and manage them for WRDS query. So let's select company name and ticker from the first column. You may select any other types of variables here if you need them, like address, city, and more. First box has all the options together, or you may go to the other boxes providing each type of variables individually. To find more about variables, you may go to Variable Descriptions. Here are the variables in detail. Or just go back to the form and browse in here while filling out the form. For example, we want the current assets of our two companies, Walmart and Amazon, not included in cash. To look for current assets, we should go to Balance Sheet Items. Here are some variables about current assets. To make sure which one is what we want, we should click on the question mark to open the description. Let's click on this one, Current Assets Total. It says, this item represents cash and other assets that are expected to be realized in cash. We don't want current assets included in cash. So let's go back and click on this one, Current Assets, Other Total. It says this item represents current assets that are not included in cash. Okay, this is what we want. So let's select it. Also, let's have some data about the company's funds used for additions to property, plant, and equipment. We should go to Cash Flow Items and select Capital Expenditure. Let's click on the question mark first to make sure it is what we want. Yes, it is the right variable. Let's select it. Conditional statement is optional and help you build unlimited statements using the list of variables, comparison operators, desired values, and logical operators. Please note, in order for a variable to be selectable in the conditional statement builder, it must first be selected in the query variable section. Finally, in step 4, we should select the format of the query output, meaning the format we want to download. For our query, let's select Excel spreadsheet. The output may be emailed or saved to your WRDS account as well. Now it is time to hit Submit Query. The screen will refresh as WRDS performs the search. Once completed, click the link to your data and then click on the file. Here is our file in Excel. If you have any further questions, please contact the librarian using this page.